welcome back. I know it's been a while since I recorded my last video, but I'm back with an updated foundation tutorial. So if you'd like to see how I do my foundation on an everyday basis whenever I do decide to wear like a full face of makeup, please stay tuned and keep on watching. Bye.
So I already have my favorite moisturizer applied, and it's by Embroilis. And then I'm going to go ahead and apply my primer, and this will help my makeup to last all day. Okay, so I'm using one of my favorite foundations, and that's the Smashbox Liquid Halo HD Foundation. And I'm using a damp Beauty Blender sponge to apply this all over my face. Now, this foundation is a light to medium coverage, so you know I do have to use a few extra pumps in order to get a full coverage look. Okay, so for highlighting, I'm using a concealer that's about a shade lighter than my complexion and the Bdellium Tools pointed foundation brush to apply this on all the areas that you'd normally highlight. So these are the places that the light would naturally hit your face. So that's underneath my eyes, down the bridge of my nose, my forehead, and my chin. And I'm using a damp Beauty Blender sponge to blend this out. Applying the concealer around my mouth where I do have some darkness. Okay, so you'll notice that I used two different color sponges, the pink one and the dark one, and it's because the pink one still has some leftover foundation on it. And I like to use it to blend out harsh lines from my highlight or from the concealer and from my contour. Okay, so I'm using that same concealer to highlight my nose, and I'm trying to create the straight line, but mine is looking a little bit crooked. But this basically would give the illusion of a slimmer, straighter nose. So it's time to add some color to my face, and I'm using Black Opal's Cream Foundation in Beautiful Bronze, and this is going to act as my contour as well as my bronzer. And of course, you're gonna have to do some serious blending to make sure everything looks even and flawless. Okay, so I'm going back in with the same pointed foundation and my concealer, and I'm going underneath my contour to define my contour even more. Thank you. With a large powder brush, I'm applying my face powder all over my face, and this is going to be used to set everything so that it doesn't move. Note, I'm not necessarily rubbing it, I'm kind of just patting it and swirling it lightly all over my face. So I'm going over my highlighted areas with the banana powder from Benai, and I like to let it sit on my face for about 2 to 3 minutes, even sometimes 5 minutes before I blend it all out. And I think this really helps to, you know, make the highlight stand out a bit more. And then now I'm going in with a second brush to kind of press the highlight into my face, as well as remove any excess product. Now to go over my contoured areas, I'm using Sleek's Contour Kit in medium and a darker foundation, a powder foundation, and I'm using a contour brush to apply this. Now I know the powder foundation looks a bit light to be used as a contour, but I promise you to the camera, it is about a shade or two darker than my complexion. And I like to use this along with the Sleek because to me, I find the Sleek to be a little bit on the cool side, so the powder foundation helps to warm it up. So I'm using the Sigma F40 brush to apply my blush, and the one that I'm using is by NYX and it's called Cinnamon, and I think this is one of my favorite blushes. Actually, it's the blush that I've been wearing almost every single day. So we're now at my favorite part of applying makeup, and that's shimmer highlights. And the one I'm using today is one of MAC's iridescent loose powders in golden bronze. And I'm applying this with a contour brush right above where I applied my blush, on my forehead using a fan brush, down the center of my nose, my cupid's bow, and my chin. And I think this just gives me a beautiful glow, very sun-kissed. Alright, so to complete this look, I'm using MAC Fix Plus, and then I'm gonna set everything with my Urban Decay Setting Spray. And that, as I said, completes the look. So I really hope you guys enjoyed. I had so much fun making this video. It feels good to be back in front of the camera. Please let me know your thoughts and your, you know, just let me know what's going on. Okay. Alright, I'm okay. Alright, bye guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, and like. And I'll see you guys in my other video.